trust, a son to cherish and to train. Those years are past and gone so fast. Now we rejoice to see his choice, to know our work was not in vain. It's hard letting go, yet in my heart I know the safest place that he can be is in your loving hands for now and all eternity. All the years to come, I know my heart will be at rest. I give to you what you deserve. I give to you my very
a girl, a gift to nurture and to love.
We thought of you with love today, but that is nothing new. We thought about you yesterday, and days before that too. We think of you in silence. We often speak your name. Now all we have are memories and your picture in a frame. Your memory is our keepsake, with which we will never part. God has you in his keeping. We have you in our hearts. Geoffrey Erlanza Trotman of Windsor Christchurch entered into rest on Wednesday, December 6, 2023, at the age of 70. Geoffrey Erlanza Trotman, son of the late Lawrence and Kathleen Trotman, father of Patrick and Richard Gaskin, Denica Hunt, Jerrin Trotman, Jenna Sandiford, and the late Fiona Gaskin. Grandfather of Ronaldo, Deontay, Beyonce, Atara, and Riche Gaskin. Yokita, Malaika, and Eric Hunt, Rajay and Rajari Gittins Trotman, and the late Maisha Grimes. Brother of Lolita King, Corrine Belgrave, Vida Boucher, Judith and Henderson Trotman, the late Iva Rose and Marcia Trotman. Cousin of Jackie Green, Julianne and Cynthia Hart. Uncle of Kevin Trotman and many others. Father-in-law of Beverly Gaskin. Relative of the Trotman, King, Hart, and Welch families. A friend of Heather Marshall, Herman Maskell, Jeanette Curtin, Ione Eastman, Paul Wiggins, Clyde Barnett, Anthony Garner, Ketonia Grant, Carlisle Burton, and many others. A service of thanksgiving to celebrate the life of Geoffrey Erlanza Trotman takes place on Thursday, December 28th, 2023, at the St. Patrick's Anglican Church, St. Patrick's, Christchurch, at 2 o'clock in the afternoon. The interment will follow in the Coral Ridge Memorial Gardens, The Ridge, Christchurch. Funeral arrangements have been entrusted to the care of S.T. Ellis Funeral and Pre-Planning Services, corner of Kensington New Road and Baxter's Road, St. Michael. You may join the family for the live streaming of the service and interment at sharingmemoriesforever.live/Geoffrey Trotman.
You can hear the songbirds singing, and you watch the clouds roll by. Then you're walking in the valley as the sun shines in a clear blue sky. You're welcoming your loved ones, and you can't believe your eyes. Yes, this earthly paradise was just around the corner. There's a house down in the valley and a house high on the hill. There is singing by the river as the water flows and turns the mill. The golden fields are waiting. Let the harvesting begin. Once the world we're living in was just around the corner. It's great to share with friends who care the things that we looked forward to. Now every tear has disappeared. The world is young and life is new. There's the sound of happy voices and the scent of new mown hay. Now you're calling to your loved ones as you start another perfect day. Then we thank our God Jehovah for his tender loving care. Yes, the blessings we all share were just around the corner. And every day smile and say how good to see your happy face. 'Cause once it seemed I only dreamed that you'd be in my warm embrace. Waiting round the corner is is a world I long to see. It's a promise from Jehovah. It's a guaranteed reality. And it's hard to get downhearted when I think of what's in store. It's the day I'm waiting for, and it's just around the corner.
Take a moment now and picture the scene. Up ahead on the path are what seem to be children laughing at play. In a world free of the fears we once faced, and taking care of this beautiful earth, are a people that live by our Father's words. Until the moon is no more, there is the peace we have been waiting. We will feel His love under the rule of His Son in the new world to come. As we see ourselves there in the new world to come. Take a moment now and think of our place. By the mountains and rivers or wide open plains, it's a place to call home. And now walking in through your front door, there is someone that you know, holding out His open arms in hopes of a tearful embrace. Feels like forever since you've been face to face. Even death won't stop our God's outstretched love in the new world to come. Hope is a fire in our hearts. Hope is an anchor that holds us firm. Hope is a light that shines like the sun as we see ourselves there in the new world to come. And every word from His mouth,
every word from His mouth,
will do all for which He sent it out. Jehovah's will for this earth,
Jehovah's
is
will for this,
fulfilling every living thing's last wish. Ourselves there in the new world to come.
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 In the new world to come.
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 now, see the love on each face, out there in the world hard to find. All these faithful friends, with the love they all show, glad to leave that old world behind. Love never fails, that's promised. It always will endure. Love, unfailing love, that's what Jehovah gives. That's what he is. Love, unfailing love, that's what we need to live. And the love here today in our heart may it stay. Unfailing love. Though sometimes it seems like the cares of this life weigh us down and feel hard to bear, giving brings us joy when we share faith and hope, comforted by God's loving care. Love will remain, that's promised. It always will endure. Love, unfailing love, that's what Jehovah gives. That's what he is. Love, unfailing love, that's what we need to live. And the love here today, in our heart may it stay. Love, unfailing love, that's what Jehovah gives. That's what he is. Love, unfailing love, that's what we need to live. And the love here today, in our heart may it stay. Unfailing love. Unfailing love. Ooh. Unfailing love.
In the quiet of the night, with a million stars above, when I think of you and of all you do, it fills my heart with love. If I give my life to you, you will always be my guide. As the days go by, you will see that I
Jesus said, I am the resurrection and I am the life. He who believes in me, though he die, he live. Lead me to never die.
Eternal God is our refuge, and underneath are the everlasting arms. With faith in Jesus Christ, we receive the body of our brother Geoffrey Erlanza for burial. Our brother was washed in holy baptism and anointed with the Holy Spirit. Let us therefore with confidence pray to God our Heavenly Father, the giver of life, that he will raise him to perfection in the company of the saints. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. O God of grace and glory, we remember before you this day our brother Geoffrey. We thank you for giving him to us, his family and friends, to know and love as a companion on our earthly pilgrimage. In your boundless compassion, console us who mourn. Give us faith to see in death the gate of eternal life, so that in quiet confidence we may continue our course on earth, until, by your call, we are reunited with those who have gone before, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Rest eternal grant unto him, O Lord.
Let thy perpetual shine upon him.
May he and all the faithful departed through the mercy of God rest in peace. Amen.
The hymn number 476.
Thank you.
Geoffrey Erlanza Trotman, better known as Boxes, Trotty, Dramatics, or Lucky, was born on March 10, 1953 to parents Lawrence and Kathleen Trotman. Unfortunately, Papi's mother passed away when he was 3 months old, so he was raised in Woburn by his aunt until his teen years. He moved back to Windsor Road with his sisters until he passed away. Papi has 6 children. Listen to this carefully. Patrick was born in July 1973. Danica was born in January 1974. And Richard was born in January 1974. So Daddy had 3 children under the age of 1 at 21 years old. Fiona was then born in 1975. 19 years later came Jerry. 3 years after him was me, Jenna. Papi worked as a security officer at the Barbados Community College for over 30 years, where he met some incredible friends. To his friends, I just want to say thank you for being there for his lunch visits when they couldn't make it. Papi was a very straight man. If there was one person that had me on my P's and Q's, it was him. If you ever had a lecture from him, you would know what I mean. Don't talk about when he vexed. The whole world will know he vexed. He faced at 100 the whole day. And he would pay at every single thing. Aunt's jarring, he would know best. Let's move on to his belly. Papi loved his belly. Once it was full, you were sure to find Mr. Trotman. And if there's meat, he's the first in the line. Papi told his granddaughters that he would be coming home for Christmas, and he wanted duck, pork, turkey, ham, and chicken. Every Saturday, you will be guaranteed to see Papi with a plate of sauce. Cornflakes and milk was his favorite thing. He would eat cornflakes and milk every day. Sometimes 2-3 in the morning, you will hear crunch, crunch, and more cornflakes being poured into a cup. I would show and say, Papi, you eating your favorite? And he would reply laughing, saying, yeah, baby. Papi was a firm believer in tough love. But if you call him to help with anything or for a listening ear, he was there. I'm not going to stand here and say he was a perfect person or he was the best father. But I can say Papi loved his children. I was extremely proud of us. Let's talk about spoiled. Papi was spoiled. I used to tell him I never met an old man so spoiled. His sisters spoiled him. He loved his sisters, and they loved him. Everything was his sisters. He would say to me, baby, Lolo say this. Baby, Vida say this. Baby, Colleen this. He was the baby in the group and the only boy from both parents. I would like to say special thanks to Aunt Lo and Aunt Vida. And I can't forget Django. Thank you for being Papi's best friend. I appreciate everything you did for him. For my family, we wish to thank you for coming to celebrate the life of Geoffrey Trotman.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Heavenly Father, in your Son Jesus Christ, you have given us a true faith and a sure hope. Strengthen this faith and hope in us all our days, that we may live as those who believe and trust in the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, and the resurrection to eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Malika Hunt will now read the first scripture reading.
Today's Bible verse is taken from Ecclesiastes 3, verses 1 to 8. For everything, there is a season, and every time for every matter under heaven, a time to be born and a time to die, a time to plant and a time to pluck up what is planted, a time to kill and a time to heal, a time to break down and a time to build up, a time to weep and a time to laugh, a time to mourn and a time to dance, a time to cast away stones and a time to gather stones together, a time to embrace and a time to refrain from embracing, a time to seek and a time to lose, a time to keep and a time to cast away, a time to tear and a time to sow, a time to silence and a time to speak, a time to love and a time to hate, a time for war and a time for peace. Here is today's reading.
Please remain sitting for the chanting of the psalm, but stand for the chanting of the last verse, Psalm 23.
Today's scripture reading is taken from 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, verse 13 to 18. But I will not have you to be ignorant, brethren, concerning them which are asleep, that ye shall sorrow not, even as others which have no hope. For if we believe that Jesus died and rose again, even so them also which sleep in Jesus will God bring with him. For this we say unto you, by the word of the Lord, that we which are alive and remain unto the coming of the Lord shall not prevent them which are asleep. For the Lord himself shall descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of the archangel, and the trump of God, and the dead in Christ shall rise first. Then we which are alive and remain shall be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air, and so shall we ever be with the Lord. Wherefore, comfort one another with these words. There ends the Bible reading.
Great is thy faithfulness, O God, my Father. Hymn number 223.
Summer and winter, springtime and harvest, sun, moon, and stars in their courses above. Join with all nature in manifold witness to thy great faithfulness, mercy, and love. May the words of my mouth and the meditation of all our hearts be always acceptable in thy sight, O Lord, our strength and our Redeemer. Amen. Please be seated. Words from the prophet Isaiah, chapter 9, verse 2. The people that walked in darkness have seen a great light. They that dwell in the land of the shadow of death, upon them hath the light shined. This evening, my friends in Christ, we are gathered here to give God thanks for the life of our brother, Geoffrey. And as we do so, we are still mindful that we are in the season of Christmas. I believe it is at this time of the year that we miss our loved ones even more. It's the time that family and friends come together to celebrate, to share, to give. And so it's a very difficult time for those of us who are grieving for our loved ones who've passed on. But in all of these circumstances, as the hymn writer tells us, through all the changing scenes of life, and trouble, joy, the word of God comes to us to bring us comfort, all those of us who are grieving for our brother. And the word comes to give us consolation. It comes to give us peace and hope. And hope, for God is still able to bring out of darkness. He's able to still bring us into the light. Into the light. The darkness will be for a while. Only for a time. But the psalmist tells us, weeping may endure for a night, but joy. Joy will come in the morning. The morning may not be tomorrow morning. It may not be the morning after. But we have the assurance, joy will come in the morning. And so we trust the word of God. We trust the word of God. And so, out of darkness, light can shine. In difficult times, it can be easy for us to lose hope. And sometimes it is hard for us to really understand all that is happening to us, all that is happening around us. But this evening's service of Thanksgiving, the prophet comes to show us that in every situation, we must rely on God. Rely on God to be with us. To be with us, the light to come and shine in our lives and shine to show us the path that we should go. And so then, it is about allowing then this sustaining presence of God's Spirit to guide us. Even in times of our pain and our sorrow, allow, like the psalm says to us, even though we walk through the valley of the shadow of death, we will fear no evil. For you are with us. For you are with us. And so it helps us to realize and to understand that irrespective of the situations or circumstances in our life, God is with us. And it is so significant that we are in the Christmas season. And so Emmanuel comes. This is what Christmas is all about. Emmanuel comes, and he comes to be with us, for us, and in us. In us. So that when the darkness comes, we know that we have someone who is there for us, who will dispel the darkness. As I always say, in his time. In his time. So who were these people who were walking in darkness that Isaiah was talking about? And these people were the oppressed in the land, and they're living in occupation, and they were poor and hungry, and they were the marginalized people in society. Just like the shepherds on the hillside, marginalized. But then we can ask the question, who were the first persons to hear about the good news of Jesus? The same marginalized people.
the same shepherds, the same persons who were out there in the darkness. And so it helps you and I to understand and realize, when we understand the incarnation and the Christmas story, God is with us. Don't matter who you think you are, and don't matter how low people may see you or think that you are not low in the eyes of Jesus. None of us are outcasts. None of us are outcasts. And they were out there all alone. But the angel came to them to bring them out of the darkness, to take them to see the light. And so for all of us this evening who mourn, brothers and sisters in Christ, remember, even in your pain and your sorrow, as we grieve for our loved one, remember, God is with you. God is with you. And so the darkness will never overcome the light. Never. So this evening, as we come to give God thanks for our brother, so many of us may be feeling at this time that we're in the darkness. Some of you may have lost your jobs. I know some people who went home at Christmas time and their employer just sent them home till next year. They didn't get any money. And so, for us, darkness is not only about not recognizing the goodness of God in our lives and accepting Jesus Christ as Lord, but darkness for us is so much, so many things. What about those for Christmas? Or even now, who may be hungry? And those who are homeless? Think about those persons. Think about those persons, not even around us, but far away from us, that the bombs are raining down on their homes every day. They're in darkness. And so it helps us to be able to see the things in our lives. And sometimes you may owe some people, you ain't got no money to pay them, and you're feeling so desperate. You want a little bit of light to shine in your life to see and be able to see how you're going to manage. How you going to manage? And so we're able to see there's so many aspects of the darkness in our lives. But this evening I want to encourage us as we look to the future. And some of us see uncertainty. Uncertainty. And we're not able to fathom the path that we should go. It's not clear. Remember. Remember. You know, Moses always used to tell the Israelites, remember. So this evening, I'm encouraging us to remember. Remember, Emmanuel comes to be with us and to stay with us and to walk with us every day through the pain and the sorrow as we grieve for our loved ones. Come, he comes to walk with us through life. Through life, brothers and sisters in Christ. So that whatever we are going through this evening, remember we have a friend. Remember we have a companion. Remember we have a comforter and a counselor and a consoler. Somebody who has promised, I will be with you always. I will never, ever leave you nor forsake you. Never. And even in death, so much sometimes when we lose our loved ones, this is the time then for us to draw close. To recognize that it's in Jesus who will come to be our comforter. We live in a world where persons are struggling. Struggling in so many ways. And as I think about Christmas and think about love and think about our brother, how he loved his family, because you know, I listen to eulogies, but I just listen to hear certain things. And for me, especially about this time of the year, it's about love. How we love each other and how we love our families. Because for me, if you don't love your family that God gave you, that family, you can't really love me. It starts with the home and the family. The children and the sisters and all the other extended members of the family. So our brother loved his family. And love came down at Christmas. God so loved that he sent Jesus. It is about the love. And so I just want you and I to capture it this evening as we leave here. The love of God. The love that God has for us. That he knows that we are going to need somebody to help us and to walk through this life with it. We are going to sing the hymn later, lead us, Heavenly Father, lead us. We need somebody to lead us. Come everybody, bunny, little bits of darkness in our lives. We need somebody to lead us and somebody who is going to guide us through the valley of the darkness, whatever it may be, so that eventually we are able to come out to see the light. And so this morning, we want to thank God for the love that our brother had for his family and shows us this evening. Do we love ours?
That's the question we could ask. Do we love ours? You know, how many of us at this Christmas and we had our lunch and we had our big dinners or whatever, and because some brother or some sister may have said something that offended us, we said that we ain't inviting her or him. Let she stay at home. And it is Christmas. And we're saying that God so loved. And these things may seem a little, you know, far-fetched, you know. But these are the little things, brothers and sisters in Christ, that you and I must think about. How we treat one another. First and foremost, how we treat our families. And then by extension, how he treated his friends. He would have treated his friends well in order for them to come and care for him while he was sick. Because you know that some people, you ain't care about them when they're well, when you're sick, they ain't bothering to have you, period. And so his friends were there for him, and coming to see him and to help his daughter care for him. Brothers and sisters in Christ, that is love. That is love. And so I want to encourage us as we leave here and as we look forward to a new year, love one another. Love one another. And it ain't hard. Love one another. This is what Jesus asked us to do. And as he sends Jesus, and Jesus shows us how we can love, you know. We don't have to look very far. Read your Bible, read the Gospels. And in the Gospels, he shows us, in spite of what persons may do to us, you can love people. And this evening, let us take that example from our brother Geoffrey. I pray that we will see this light, Jesus, the light of the world, shining in our hearts. And all we need to do, as the song said, oh, come to my heart, Lord Jesus, there's room in my heart for you. Open our hearts to receive the light of Christ. And so that you and I then can go into the world to shine as lights in the world in all the dark places that are there. So that we can be light shining to these persons, to let people understand Jesus has come. Jesus is here, and he's here not only in the world, but he can be here in our lives to show us how we can live, to show us the path of life that we can take, to show us that even when the darkness comes, unemployment, sickness, hunger, homelessness, whatever it may be, he is able to bring us out. And we can help each other too by bringing each other out, by doing for each other what God enables us to do. So if you know your sister or your brother or your neighbor or somebody hungry, you have your food in your tea, don't keep all in your larder or your cupboard or your fridge. Go out and feed somebody. Go and feed somebody. Go and love somebody. Go and care for somebody. Go and sit quietly somewhere with somebody and just be a presence to somebody who's lonely. And as we greet for those we love, don't only come today to be with them, but you check on the family sometimes and see how they're doing. Because if you and I do not hold and capture the love of God and more or less live it out in our lives, we ain't getting very far. We're not going to get very far. And so this evening, as we give God thanks for the life of our brother, we thank God for sending his son Jesus into the world, but most importantly, into our lives. That by the way we live, we can make a difference in our families, in our communities, in our workplaces, wherever God has placed us. Wherever people lead a way of hope, that as we believe there is hope for us and hope for the world because Jesus lives, then you and I can share a little bit of hope with somebody who's feeling despondent and frustrated with life. You don't know who you may be saving from committing suicide. If you just pause sometimes and just have a kind word to say to somebody. Even hello, how you doing? Because when you say that, sometimes you hear so much. And you and I must be willing to be there for one another. Take it from our brother. And so as we give God thanks for his life this evening, whatever darkness you are in, trust Jesus. Trust Jesus to help you, to guide you, to direct you, and most importantly, to dispel the darkness. So that you too can see the light. And as we see the light, then, like Jesus did, we go into the world to share that light with our family, with our friends, and with the communities, and with our neighbors, who happens to be anybody that we meet. This evening, we commend him to the love and to the mercy of God, the God who made him. And we commend him, and we place him back into the hands of the God who made him. And we pray there he will find rest and peace.
And as we continue our Christian journey, brothers and sisters in Christ, Jesus comes to dispel the darkness in our lives. Amen.
Congregation, we stand up.
Let us now with faith and confidence, we say the Apostles' Creed on page 5. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and was born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Please kneel for the prayers.
We pray for those who mourn, and we commemorate the departed Geoffrey Erlanza. After each petition, your response shall be, hear our prayer. Let us pray with confidence to God our Father, who raised our Lord Jesus from the dead for the salvation of all. Grant, Lord, that your servant may know the fullness of life which you have promised to those who love you. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Be close to those who mourn. Increase their faith in your undying love. Lord, in your mercy, may we be strengthened in our faith, live the rest of our lives in fellowship with your Son, and be ready when you call us to the fullness of life. Lord, in your mercy, show your mercy to the dying, strengthen them with hope, and fill them with the peace and joy of your presence. Lord, in your mercy, we commend all people to your unfailing love, that in them your will may be fulfilled. And we rejoice at the faithful witness of your saints in every age, praying that we share with them in your eternal kingdom, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Lord, in your mercy, let us pray. Father in heaven, you gave your Son Jesus Christ to suffering and to death on the cross, and raised him to life in glory. Grant us a patient faith in time of darkness, and strengthen our hearts with the knowledge of your love, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Let us pray. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Grant us, Lord, the wisdom and the grace to use aright the time that is left us here on earth. Lead us to repent of our sins, the evil we have done, and the good we have failed to do. And strengthen us to follow the steps of your Son in the way that leads to the fullness of eternal life, through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Let us commend our brother Geoffrey Erlanza to the mercy of God, our Maker and Redeemer. Heavenly Father, by your mighty power, you have given us new life in Christ Jesus. We entrust Geoffrey to your merciful keeping in the faith of Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who died and rose again to save us and is now alive and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit in glory forever. Amen. Rest eternal grant to him, O Lord. May he and all the faithful departed to the tender mercy of God rest in peace. Amen. On behalf of the church family here at St. Patrick, the church council, I take this opportunity to extend sincere condolences to the relatives and friends of our brother Geoffrey and to assure you of the church's continual prayers. May God continue to comfort, strengthen, and sustain you in your days of mourning. He will give you a garland in his time. God bless you.
A collection towards the upkeep of the cemetery will be taken during the singing of the hymn, Lead Us, Heavenly Father, Lead Us, number 424.
Please stand. Please stand. Please stand.
trampling down death by death and giving life to those in the tomb. The Son of Righteousness is gloriously risen, giving light to those who sat in darkness and in the shadow of death. The Lord will guide our feet into the way of peace, having taken away the sin of the world. Christ will open the kingdom of heaven to all who believe in his name, saying, "Come, O blessed of my Father, inherit the kingdom prepared for you. Into paradise may the angels lead you. At your coming may the martyrs receive you and bring you into the holy city, Jerusalem."
Thank you. the answer to it all. Jesus, you wipe away all tears, you mend the broken heart. You're the answer to it all, to it all. Jesus, yeah. Way make miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness. My God, that is who you are. Way make miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness. My God, that is who you are. You are here, touching every life. I worship you. I worship you. You are here, meeting every need. I worship you. I worship you. Oh, devotion day,
I was drawn to what I could not understand. But for the cause of Christ, I have spent my days believing that what He'd have me be is who I am. As I come to see the weaker side of me, grace is what I'll need. Sin demanded justice for my soul. Mercy said no. I'm not gonna let you go. I'm not gonna let you slip away.
No, I'm not gonna let you go.
gives to me will come to me. I will never turn away anyone who believes in me. He who raised Jesus Christ from the dead will also give new life to our mortal bodies through his indwelling spirit. My heart therefore is glad and my spirit rejoices. My body also shall rest in hope. You will show me the path of life. In your presence there is fullness of joy, and in your right hand are pleasures forevermore. I heard a voice from heaven saying, write this. Happy are the dead who die in the faith of Christ. Henceforth, says the Spirit, they may rest from their labors, for they take with them the record of their deeds. Man born of a woman has but a short time to live. Like a flower he blossoms and then withers. Like a shadow he flees and never stays. In the midst of life we are in death. To whom can we turn for help? But to you, Lord, who are justly angered by our sins. Lord God, holy and mighty, holy and immortal, holy and most merciful Savior, deliver us from the bitter pains of eternal death. You know the secrets of our hearts. In your mercy, hear our prayer. Forgive us our sins. And at our last hour, let us not fall away from you. In sure and certain hope of resurrection to eternal life through our Lord Jesus Christ, we commend to Almighty God our brother Geoffrey Erlanza, and we commit his body to the ground. Earth to earth, ashes to ashes, dust to dust. And we beseech you in your infinite goodness to give us grace to live in your dear love and to die in your favor, that when your well-beloved Son shall come again in judgment, both this our brother Geoffrey and we ourselves may be found acceptable in your sight. Grant this for the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. Almighty God, with whom still live the spirits of those who die in the Lord, and with whom the souls of the faithful are in joy and felicity, we give you heartfelt thanks for the good examples of all your servants, who having finished their course in faith, now find rest and refreshment. May we, with all who have died in the true faith of your holy name, have perfect fulfillment and bliss in your eternal and everlasting glory, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Remember all those who are grieving for our brother Geoffrey. Grant, O Lord, to all who are bereaved the spirit of faith and courage, that they may have strength to meet the days to come with steadfastness and patience, not sorrowing as those without hope, but in thankful remembrance of your great goodness and in the joyful expectation of eternal life with those they love. And this we ask in the name of Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Rest eternal grant to him, O Lord. May he and all the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. Amen.
Thank you.
Chains fell off, my heart was free. I rose, went forth, and followed thee.
The Lord be with you. Let us pray. Remember, O Lord, this your servant who has gone before us with a sign of faith and now rests in the sleep of peace. According to your promises, grant to him and to all who rest in Christ refreshment, light, and peace through the same Christ, our Lord. Amen. The Lord bless him and keep him. The Lord make his face to shine upon him and be gracious to him. The Lord lift up his countenance upon him and give him peace. Amen. Amen. Unto him that is able to keep us from falling and to present us faultless before the presence of his glory with exceeding joy. To the only wise God, our Savior, be glory and majesty, dominion and power, both now and forever. Amen. The Lord be with you. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Run down here, come on, let me see you. trouble. Goodbye to my trouble. So long.